A good day of football yesterday. K-State came back and won. KU was winning through three quarters and looked a lot better, but ended up falling to OU. So nothing to be ashamed of for KU. And Missouri didn't play. So there you go. Sporting KC did beat Seattle at Seattle, so they're within a match of Seattle. So hopefully they will be able to pull that out. And the Chiefs play today at Tennessee. It's going to be a tough game, but this might be the beginning of our championship run. So good luck to our Chiefs. All right. As I mentioned last week, the Wellness Center survey should be emailed to you if we have your email, or there's paper ones on the round table in the back. Please fill those out, whether you utilize it or not. Knights of Columbus is chili supper. And Bingo Night is on Saturday, October 30th. And then on Halloween, the 31st, the Knights will be hosting a parish breakfast from 9 a.m. to noon. More details are in the bulletin. Zoom workshop on the ecological conversion by the Green Team is Tuesday evening, October 26th, and Wednesday morning, the 27th. Either one is fine. Those lost and found items in the gathering space, those will be gone after today. So if you have something in there, please grab them. If you need an umbrella, there's three nice ones back there. Trunk or Treat is in the parking lot tonight from 6:30 to 7:30. Youth group will be having a Halloween haunt at Worlds of Fun this Friday evening. Their permission slips are on the website. And then remember, as we approach November, we will honor our deceased loved ones with the photos in the area of remembrance of the North Alcove. All Saints Day is not a holy day this year because it's on a Monday. So November 1st is not a holy day. All Saints Day is not a holy day because there is no Mass here. But Tuesday, on All Souls Day, we will be having a Mass like we do every year for all of our deceased loved ones who have gone before us, and also especially those who have gone in the last year. Okay. Today is World Mission Sunday. The special collection for the Society for the Propagation of the Faith supports the works of the missions of the church. There are envelopes for that on the gathering space, but always, always remember, if you send in those envelopes with your name and address, they're going to start mailing you stuff, wanting more money. And then they will sell your name and address to other companies who will start mailing you stuff and want more money. So be careful. I'm just giving you a heads up. All right, who's celebrating birthdays this week? We got a birthday back here. When's your birthday? Today, and how old are you?
How old are you?
5. Happy birthday. Yay. So adorable. Others, right here. Tomorrow, happy birthday. October the 12th, happy birthday to you. Is that it? Oh, back here, Joyce. Thursday, happy birthday early. Any anniversaries? Okay, so this is the 8 o'clock Mass. This is the one we're providing on Facebook and YouTube. So all those who are watching at home, if you're celebrating a birthday or anniversary, happy, happy day.
Let us sing number 837, Gather Your People, number 837.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace of God our Father and our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. My brothers and sisters, as we prepare to meet the Lord in word and sacrament, let us call to mind our sins and turn to our Lord for his mercy. Lord Jesus, you heal the blind and the lame. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are near to the brokenhearted. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are the high priest who pleads for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, increase our faith, hope, and charity, and make us love what you command, so that we may merit what you promise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. Thus says the Lord, shout with joy for Jacob, exult at the head of the nations, proclaim your praise to him and say, the Lord has delivered his people, the remnant of Israel. Behold, I will bring them back from the land of the north. I will gather them from the ends of the world with the blind and the lame in their midst, the mothers and those with child. They shall return as an immense throng. They departed in tears, but I will console them and guide them. I will lead them to brooks of water on a level road so that none shall stumble. For I am a father to Israel. Ephraim is my firstborn. The word of the Lord.
The Lord has done great things for us. We are filled with joy. When the Lord brought back the captives of Zion, we were like men dreaming. Then our mouth was filled with laughter, and our tongue with rejoicing. Has done great things for them. The Lord has done great things for us. We are glad indeed. The Lord has done great things for us. We are filled with joy.
Restore our fortunes, O Lord, like the
that sow in tears shall reap rejoicing. The Lord has done great things for us. We are filled with joy. Although they go forth weeping, carrying the seed to be sown, they shall come back rejoicing, carrying their sheaves. The Lord has done great things for us. We are filled with joy.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, every high priest is taken from among men and made their representative before God to offer gifts and sacrifices for sins. He is able to deal patiently with the ignorant and the erring, for he himself is beset by weakness, and so, for this reason, must make sin offerings for himself as well as for the people. No one takes this honor upon himself, but only when called by God, just as Aaron was. In the same way, it was not Christ who glorified himself in becoming high priest, but rather the one who said to him, "You are my son, this day I have begotten you." Just as he says in another place, "You are a priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Jesus Christ destroyed death and brought life to light through the gospel. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. As Jesus was leaving Jericho with his disciples and a sizable crowd, Bartimaeus, a blind man, the son of Timaeus, sat by the roadside begging. On hearing that it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to cry out and say, Jesus, son of David, have pity on me. And many rebuked him, telling him to be silent, but he kept calling out all the more, Son of David, have pity on me. Jesus stopped and said, call him. So they called the blind man, saying to him, take courage, get up, Jesus is calling you. He threw aside his cloak, sprang up, and came to Jesus. Jesus said to him in reply, what do you want me to do for you? The blind man replied to him, Master, I want to see. Jesus told him, go your way. Your faith has saved you. Immediately he received his sight and followed him on the way. The Gospel of the Lord. Remember last week in the gospel, we heard Jesus asking James and John, what would you like me to do for you? And James and John, they both wanted to sit at the right and the left of Jesus in his glory. This time, this week, we hear Jesus asking Bartimaeus, a blind man, what would you want me to do for you? He doesn't want glory, he just wants a chance. He wants to see. He has been blind. He has nothing. The only thing he has is that cloak. That cloak is what keeps him warm at night. That cloak is what he sits on the day to beg, to get money, in order to buy food, in order to eat. He's heard of Jesus because he calls out to him because he has faith that Jesus can help him to see. And he gives him the title of Son of David. So he has a pretty good clue who Jesus is, and he does believe pretty strongly that Jesus can heal him. So he throws his cloak aside, his security. You know, those of you who have children and grandchildren, when you get rid of the security blanket that your child has or grandchild, you know how hard that is? It's harder for Bartimaeus. But he does get healed. Jesus tells him to go on his way. You are healed. You can see. So now he can see. Now he can work. Now he can make money. But he is healed even deeper because he now sees that the road to follow is Christ. And so he disobeys Jesus. He doesn't go on his own way. He starts following Jesus. And that's what we're called to do too. Jesus is constantly asking us, what would you like me to do for you? What do we want Jesus to do for us? I think the best thing we can ask for is, help me to see. I want to see, like Bartimaeus. Because a lot of times we don't realize how bad our vision can be. Spiritually, it's like those of you who have glasses, you know, when your prescription is off and your vision slowly gets worse and you just kind of adjust to it and you don't really realize how bad it is until you get those new glasses, and then everything is crisp and clear and you have to adjust because it looks like everything's going downhill at first. But once we start seeing differently, things open up, the path to heaven, the path of Christ. But we have to be careful not to think that we have perfect vision in this world, because we don't. We are not Christ. The best thing we can do is asking Jesus, I would like to see. And the more we do that, the more we will see. With our heart and with our soul. Okay, I've kept this pretty short because this is the second week of our annual Catholic appeal. Last week we heard Bishop Johnson speak to us about the appeal for the diocese and the ministries down there. Today we have Chris Larkey, our business manager, who's going to talk to us about the appeal, our annual stewardship appeal here at the parish level.
So as Father Jeff mentioned, we're in our annual stewardship appeal. This year, the theme for the diocesan appeal is from Ephesians, to equip the holy ones for the work of ministry, for building up the body of Christ. The diocese sent me an email Friday saying that they took all the stewardship packets to the post office Friday, so you should be receiving them this week. In that packet, you'll have your diocesan pledge card, your parish pledge card, and your parish time and talent ministry card. So if you could fill those out and bring them in next weekend, we'll appreciate that. This weekend, I'm going to focus on our parish stewardship renewal, asking you once again to renew your commitments of sharing your time, talent, and treasure with our parish. All three of these are vital to the workings of our parish. Your commitments of treasure, your donations, go to keep our parish up and running. Every time I walk across the parking lot, I wonder how long it will last, how much longer. We also have the church roof that will need repaired in the near future. These big projects, along with the everyday costs of running the parish, the utilities, the salaries, liturgical and office supplies, just to name a few, are why your contributions are so important to our parish. Thank you to all that give so generously. If you currently aren't donating or are under donating, please prayerfully consider sharing your gifts of treasure with the parish. If every family donated something, our parish could do so much more, and it will continue to be a healthy and thriving parish. Behind me, you can see the banners representing the many ministries that we have here at St. Sabina. These ministries are made possible by the sharing of time and talent of so many of you. There are many ways that you can join in and help. Helping at church was something that my family had always done when I was growing up. So I felt the call to serve since I was very little. I began serving in ministry, visiting the sick and the homebound, and one thing has led to another. And here I am, blessed to be able to continue serving in ministry, which has given me so many rewards. I have often felt very humbled at being able to help others in need, but I never felt as humbled as I have these past couple of months, because for the first time, I was on the receiving end. On August 15th, my husband Mike was in a bicycle accident and broke 10 bones, three of which were vertebrae. He was in the hospital a week and then home in a neck and back brace until just a week and a half ago. So many of you sent us cards, prayed for us, brought us meals, and we are ever so grateful. Being the recipients of so much care and concern is quite a bit different than being the giver. Having so many people reach out to us was like the comfort of a blanket wrapped around us. We didn't have to go through it alone. It was hard to juggle Mike's care, all of his medical appointments, and my responsibilities here at the parish. He wasn't supposed to be home for more than a couple hours at a time, so I was able to work a lot from home. But a few times when I had to be here longer for funerals, parishioners even came out to the house to sit with Mike and care for him. The care, the concern, the love, and the prayers, and the help that we can give to one another is now my definition of a parish family. As a parish, we come together each week not only to worship our loving God, but to me, to be community to each other. Without this parish community of St. Sabina, I don't know how we would have gotten through the past couple of months. Thank you. Mike is doing well. We are blessed he will make a full recovery. So I invite each of you to continue to help build up the body of Christ right here at St. Sabina. Get to know the people you sit next to each week. If you have time, join one of our many ministries. You'll not only be helping others, you'll be getting to know other parishioners and building relationships and friendships with them. Take a look at the banners and see what appeals to you. And together, we can continue to build up the body of Christ. Thank you.
Thank you, Chris. I always preach, take one small step. You can stand. Take one small step. You know, just do one thing extra here at St. Sabina and see where God leads you. You just never know where God can lead you. You know, you could be H2 and be carrying the cross in the entrance procession. Or forgetting. Okay, that's an inside joke. Okay, let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, one was with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come. Amen. Jesus asked Bartimaeus, "What do you want me to do for you?" Confident in his care for us, let us not hesitate to place our needs before our Lord.
For the Holy Church of God, that we may be a healing presence to all the people of the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the youth of the world, that their vision, strength, passion, and enthusiasm will bring to birth a new era of compassion and justice in the world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who seek to spread the good news through their work in the church's missions, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For doctors, nurses, counselors, and all who work in the healing professions, and for all who work to develop new treatments and cures, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick, may they receive the healing born of faith. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all gathered here, may we be healed from every spiritual blindness so as to focus our gaze on Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially Denise English, may they be gathered to that great company whom God will lead to the waters of eternal life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Good and gracious God, you have filled us with joy at the works you have done in our world. Hear our prayers and graciously grant them according to your will. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
As we prepare our gifts, let us sing, "I Have Loved You." You may find it at number 588. number 588.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look, we pray, O Lord, on the offerings we make to your majesty, that whatever is done by us in your service may be directed above to your glory through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, thrones, dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. You have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you humbly. We pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, James, our Bishop, the clergy, and all your children. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At our Savior's command and for my divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. And with your spirit. Let us offer to each other a sign of Christ's peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and so shall be the body.
Our communion song, We Remember, may be found at number 681, number 681.
We remember how you loved us to your death, and still we celebrate, for you are with us here, and we believe that we will see you.
one among us into human time.
Do we have any newly instructed hospitality ministers here this morning? If we do, please stand up. Okay, good. We're going to have a special blessing for, since we're talking about our stewardship, and one of the ministries is hospitality, which is a very easy and friendly and fun thing to do. It's just greeting people as they come in and helping out, like with coffee and such. So my dear friends in Christ, let us pray with confidence to the Father, and let us ask him to bestow his blessings upon our brother and sister chosen and prepared to be ministers of hospitality. God of glory, your beloved Son has shown us that true worship comes from humble and contrite hearts. Bless our brothers and sisters who have responded to the needs of our parish and wish to serve as ministers of hospitality. May their presence make all who enter our church feel welcome in his house, and grant that their ministry may be fruitful and our worship pleasing in your sight. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Okay, you may sit down. Do we have any new altar servers? Nope. One? Who? Oh, yeah, you're new. Stand up. Lord Jesus Christ, you love children so much that you said, "Let the children come to me, for the kingdom of God belongs to such as these." Bless this altar server and all our altar servers who help them to serve with reverence in every sacred celebration, and grant that the light of Christ may shine in their hearts. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And let us pray. May your sacraments, O Lord, we pray, perfect in us what lies within them, that what we now celebrate in signs, we may one day possess in truth, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. We go in peace to love and serve our Lord.
Let us sing number 685, How Can I Keep From Singing? Number 685.
My life goes on in endless song of harvest lamentation. I hear the clear, though far off, hymn that hails a new creation. No storm can shake my inmost calm, for to that rock I'm clinging. Christ is Lord of heaven and earth, how can I keep from singing? Through all the tumult and the strife, I hear that music ringing. It finds and echoes in my soul, how can I keep from singing? No storm can shake my inmost calm, while to that rock I'm clinging.
to